Hey everybody, I'm Scott Hardman. I'm a researcher here at the Institute of Transportation Studies, working in the Plug-in Hybrid and Electric Vehicle Research Center at UC Davis. And today I'm going to be giving a mini lecture as part of our new mini lecture series on electric vehicle markets. Okay, so first of all, a little bit of background. There are two different types of electric vehicles on the market today. The first is battery electric vehicles and then plug-in hybrid electric vehicles. Battery electric vehicles are powered only by the battery. They typically have a range of around 100 miles to 300 miles on one charge, and they're around $30,000 to $100,000 to purchase. And then next we have plug-in hybrids. Now they differ from electric vehicles because they still have a gasoline engine. So they normally have a shorter electric driving range, maybe 12 to 50 miles. And then after that range is depleted, you will continue your journey using the internal combustion engine. And the prices for those, again, are around similar prices, $25,000 to $100,000. And so the technology for electric vehicles and plug-in hybrids has been changing since they were introduced around 2011, 2012. And in particular, you can see on this chart, which is showing the kilowatt hours of battery packs of electric vehicles. So you can see this is increasing. So since 2011 to 2012, we've seen a gradual increase of average battery pack sizes from around 25 kilowatt hours to now around 70. And what that means is we're seeing vehicles that could drive 100 miles back in 2011, 2012, 2013, to vehicles today that can drive closer to 250 and 300 miles. And we haven't seen a significant change in plug-in hybrid electric vehicles yet, but we are seeing car companies announce more plug-in hybrids that will have longer driving ranges that will be introduced into the future. Okay, and then a final type of electric vehicle that I should mention is fuel cell electric vehicles. This is different again, and this vehicle is powered by a fuel cell which is fueled by hydrogen. The hydrogen is stored on board in a tank and it's supplied to the fuel cell, which provides electricity to drive the vehicles. And to refuel one of these vehicles, you'd have to go to a centralized hydrogen filling station, which would be very much like a gas station. You'd fill up in 3 to 5 minutes, and then you could go continue on your journey. There are much fewer of these vehicles being sold today than plug-in hybrids and battery electric vehicles. And in California, the place where there are actually more fuel cell vehicles than anywhere else in the world, there are around 39 locations where you can refuel the vehicles. Okay, and so this is the availability of different electric vehicle models globally. So this includes plug-in hybrids, battery electric vehicles, and fuel cell vehicles. And we consider a vehicle to be available if it was sold in that year. So you can see globally, we've been seeing a sharp increase in the number of vehicles for sale beginning in 2008, when a few vehicles were offered for sale, and to 2018, when there are now more than 500 vehicles available for people to choose from. The US is showing a similar trend, but slightly fewer vehicles available. This started picking up in sort of 2010, and in 2018, there were 52 different vehicle models people could choose from. The number's a little bit lower so far in 2019. It's in the high 40s of models that are available. That's partly because some of the older electric vehicles with around 100 miles of range are no longer being sold, and we're seeing sort of new models coming on the market. But again, more choice for consumers, and we're seeing a gradual increase in the number of electric vehicles people can choose from. Okay, so now I'm going to go over some global electric vehicle markets. So this chart here is showing the annual sales of plug-in electric vehicles from 2008 to 2018 for the top electric vehicle markets in the world, and then at the top you have all the other nations. So you can see from this, sales began in sort of 2010, 2011. They were a little bit slow to increase until maybe 2015, when growth became quite rapid. And in 2011, 2012, 2013, 2014, the largest market for electric vehicles was the United States. But you can see the dark blue bar at the bottom of this chart, that's China. So since 2015, China has been growing very rapidly. It's now the largest electric vehicle market in the world. And in 2018, they made up around 50% of the entire global electric vehicle market. So this chart is showing global electric vehicle sales. So it's the top selling models in 2019 so far. So this is for the first 5 months of 2019. So you can see that the Tesla Model 3 So far this year, that is the best-selling electric vehicle, close to 90,000 of those sold. And then if you look at the rest of the list, actually a lot of these vehicles are Chinese-made electric vehicles, like the one you can see in red, the second best-selling electric vehicle, the BJ EV EU series, which is a small electric sedan sold in the Chinese market. And then third, we have the Nissan Leaf. And a lot of these vehicles are full battery electric vehicles, apart from the BYD Tang plug-in hybrid and the Mitsubishi Outlander plug-in hybrid. All the other vehicles in that list are full battery electric vehicles. And a lot of them, you can see, they are Chinese-made ones, with the exception of the Tesla Model 3, the Nissan Leaf, the Mitsubishi Outlander, and the Renault Zoe. And the Renault Zoe is an interesting one because that's mostly sold in Europe. So to see that in this list is a little bit surprising, but it shows how well that vehicle's doing in Europe. The Tesla Model 3 is getting close to the Renault Zoe in Europe, but for now, that's the best-selling electric vehicle there. Okay, so now I'm gonna move on and talk about the US market. So again, the US market is experiencing a lot of growth. So this chart is showing battery electric vehicle sales, plug-in hybrid electric vehicle sales, and then the small thin line that you can see at the top beginning to emerge in 2018, that is fuel cell electric vehicle sales. And so you can see that it's been increasing somewhat steadily, but then in 2019, there was a substantial increase. And you can see from the chart that most of that increase came from battery electric vehicles. But there's one reason for this. So now if we separate out Tesla battery electric vehicle sales shown here in the yellow color, you can see that most of the market growth has been actually due to just one automaker. And if you look at the blue bar at the very bottom of the graph, that is all other electric vehicles, you can see that that's actually really not growing that much. So for now, the market is quite dependent on just one automaker, and that's where we're seeing growth. And then plug-in hybrids, the light blue at the top, that's sort of steadily been increasing. Okay, and the next slide is showing the top 12 electric vehicle markets by state in the US for 2018. And so on the left-hand axis, we have annual sales, and on the right-hand axis, we have percentage of the new vehicles sold in that state that would be electric. And so you can see that California is leading the market. Around 160,000 electric vehicles were sold there in 2018. And about 8% of the market was electric, which includes plug-in hybrids, battery electric vehicles, and fuel cell vehicles. And then the next highest state by volume is New York, which is Florida, Washington, Texas. All these states have lower volumes than California. The next highest state by percent of the market is Washington. And then actually that's followed by Oregon, which isn't shown here because Oregon has quite a small volume of sales. And then this is the top selling electric vehicle models in the United States for 2019. And you can see sort of the same trend we were seeing in 2018 with Tesla being a substantial part of the battery electric vehicle market. You can see that again, Tesla is about 51% of all plug-in hybrid or battery electric vehicles sold were Tesla electric vehicles. You see the Model 3 was the best-selling electric vehicle in the United States so far in 2019, which is followed by the plug-in Prius, which is a plug-in hybrid electric vehicle, and then the Chevrolet Bolt. Okay, so just briefly, I want to talk about what's driving the market because this doesn't, you know, happen spontaneously. I think other mini lectures will talk about this in more detail, but just for context, I wanted to mention it. I tend to think about the market as being driven by three aspects. So the first is regulation. In the United States, we have the corporate average fuel economy standards, which is pushing automakers to increase the average fuel economy of their vehicles. And then in California and the other states that follow California's zero emission vehicle regulation, we have a regulation that mandates automakers to sell a certain percentage of their vehicles that are electric vehicles. So that is the sort of regulatory side that is encouraging automakers to sell more electric vehicles. The next thing is incentives. So electric vehicles represent quite a behavior change for consumers. So and they are more expensive than conventional gasoline powered vehicles. So governments are offering purchase incentives like the $7,500 federal tax credit. And in California, if you buy a battery electric vehicle, you'd get $2,500 from the state as a rebate. And then there are also what we call indirect or perhaps non-financial incentives. For example, if you buy an electric vehicle in California, you can get an HOV lane sticker, which means you can drive in the carpool lane with just one occupant in the vehicle. And then finally, the other thing that I tend to think about is consumer preferences. So we are seeing some shifts in consumers in the types of vehicles they want to buy. We're seeing people have preferences for sort of high technology, slightly more environmentally conscious vehicles with lower emissions, people starting to see value in the cost saving of electric vehicles, and then even people seeing the value in being able to charge an electric vehicle from home so that they never have to visit a gas station. So these are the sort of the three things that we think about as driving the electric vehicle market. And I think they'll be covered more in future mini lectures, and I'll leave it there. Thank you.